Hallelujah. Those that know Lamont Naimo, God, we bless your name. Hallelujah. We witness, oh God, hallelujah, the culmination, oh God, hallelujah, of courtship, oh God, of friendship. And we just bless you today, God. We thank you, Father, as these lives are joined, oh God, hallelujah. We thank you for the great things, God, that you will release through their lives, oh God. The great things, God, that you will do in them, oh God, and through them, Father. We just bless your name, God. We honor you today, God. Hallelujah. Father, for the victories, God. The victories, both natural and spiritual, God, that Naima and Lamont will see, God. We glorify your name, God, that they will lift up a holy standard in their marriage, in the name of Jesus, a holy standard with their children, a holy standard in their community, a holy standard, oh God, with everyone they come in contact with, God. We bless your name, God. We thank you, Father, hallelujah, that you have joined them in love, hallelujah. We thank you, Father, they will lean upon you. We thank you, Father, that you will be the center of their marriage, oh God. We thank you, Father, for their prophetic destiny, God. We glorify your name, God. We glorify your name that we are here to witness, oh God, the beginnings of a blessed marriage. Hallelujah. We thank you for the koinonia, God, the fellowship, God. We thank you, Father, for your sweet presence, God. Lord, let the marriage bring forth a sweet smell and savor before you, God, to honor your name, God. That Lamont and Naima will live, oh God, hallelujah, to honor your name. Hallelujah. That this marriage will honor your name, God. And many will see it, oh God, and glorify your name. Many will see it, God. Hallelujah. And they will be blessed. And they will say, we need to get married. We need to honor God the way that they've done. We give you praise, God, that you will make them an example, oh God. Hallelujah. That you would make them, Lord, you would set them up, God. Hallelujah. To be an example to many, God. To be pillars, oh God, in the community, God. Hallelujah. That people will see them, God, and glorify your name. Hallelujah. And say, there's a godly couple. And we bless you today, God. We bless you today. We speak blessings over Naima, oh God, and Lamont today. Bless them, God. We thank you for richly, God, blessing them. We thank you, Father, the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich and it addeth no sorrow. We give you praise. This is a time of joy and celebration. And we say hallelujah to the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Hallelujah to the Lord of Glory. Hallelujah. That joins our brother and our sister, our niece, oh God, our nephew, God. Somebody, hallelujah, give God a praise for what he has done. This is not a solemn assembly. This is a time to rejoice. Hallelujah. For the marriage bed is honorable. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You said marriage is honorable, oh God, and the bed undefiled. We glorify your name, God, that Naima, oh God, and Lamont desire to honor you, oh God. Honor you with their lives, oh God. We thank you, Father, they lift up the standard, oh God. And they will keep it lifted, God. They will raise, oh God, the bar in the community, God. We bless your name today, God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. As a reference point, God, people will point and say, yes, I see a godly couple. We bless your name. You say we're living epistles read of all men. People will watch them and read them and see Jesus. We glorify your name, oh God. Hallelujah. Let's give God a praise. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we thank you, God. We celebrate. Hallelujah. You join in two lives today, God. Our very own, our precious ones, God. We give you praise. We give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. You're such a wonderful God. Such a wonderful God. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God a praise. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We give you praise. Hallelujah. And we're just going to read some scripture before the Lord. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. Two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat, but how can one warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him. And a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Hallelujah. We give you praise. And a familiar passage to many, 1 Corinthians 13. Hallelujah. On this day, as we celebrate what God is doing in Naeem and Lamont's life, it is appropriate for us to read the love chapter. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not going to read the whole thing. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 13, starting at verse 4. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up, doth not behave itself unseemingly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth, beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth. Amen. Give God a praise. Hallelujah.
I got somebody that looks better than you and say, I want to look like you tomorrow.
I want to look like you tomorrow.
Turn this down some. I just want to greet you, welcome you to this joyous occasion. Turn this down some, please. Sister Melissa is going to minister and dance.
Just a cover word, describe me who you are.
so lovely. Want everyone to know why I'm in love with you.
No matter what I face, you've been there to bring me through just fine. On time, it took a while to see that your love was true.
Now no one can
undo.
I belong
to you
until the end
of time.
Good to know.
Good to know you're mine.
And all I want
to say
till my dying
day,
I just wanna be close to you.
Honey and sweet heaven is where I wanna be, where I am when I'm with you.
Perfect, yes, perfect. You gave for all the world to see. Now no one can
undo.
'Cause I belong
to you
until the end
of time.
Good to know.
You're
and all I want,
all I wanna say to you
till my dying, I just wanna be close to you.
Come on, Stacey. Follow me.
Da-da.
You say.
Da-da.
Da-da. Da-da-da. Da-da. Da-da-da. Da-da. Da-da.
Da-da.
Go out to see, but now we know the truth. And no one
now
can.
No one can. I
can't. Wanna be close to you.
It's been 5 years. Can't hold back my tears, 'cause I'm just so happy I'm marrying an angel today.
Yes.
As I take your hand, I pledge to be your man. I vow to trust, to love, to cherish, and never disrespect the love we share. I'll be honest, I cannot lie. There'll be real good days, there'll be some bad times. I'll be standing right beside you, my sweet lady, me and my love of mine. Oh, and we take this ring.
Yes.
And I place it on your sweet, lovely hand. We would tell our kids, they will show their kids what mom and daddy did on the day I married my angel. Oh. da. There'll be real good days, there'll be some bad times. I'll be standing right beside you, my sweet lady, me and my love of mine. Oh, as I take this ring and I place it on your sweet, lovely hand, we will show our kids, they will tell their kids what mom and daddy did on the day I married my angel. Oh, on the day I married my angel.
Yes.
On the day I married my angel. Yeah. On the day I married my angel. Yeah. On the day I married my angel.
I give myself away. Oh no. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me.
All right.
Give myself away. Oh, no, no. I give myself away so you can use me.
My life is not my own.
My life is not my own. To you I give myself to you. Ooh, my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you.
Who gives this bride?
I do.
Amen. Y'all just remain standing. Let's just pray. Now, Father, we thank you for your presence. And Jesus, you are invited. We ask that you would be the unseen guest, that this union would be honored with your presence. And so we thank you for being here. Bless them, increase them, empower them, in Jesus' name. Now before you sit, let me just charge you. You know, this is, it's not City Hall. This is the house of God, and you are witnesses. If you see them acting outside of the marriage union, you have a right and a responsibility to tell them that that's wrong, because you have been invited as witnesses to this holy matrimony.
Amen.
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 And you may be seated. You still here? Hello? You get married over here? All right. You sure? Amen. I don't have any notes, but I have instructions. All right, I can do that. Well, welcome everyone. You know, what's interesting is, what is marriage? And many times everyone wants to get married. And many times marriages don't last because they didn't know what marriage was. And when you find out from God what is marriage, what God says is, marriage is a union where two people come together to be one person. And what God did was, he uses marriage to show his relationship to the church, because the members in the church are considered or called the bride, and Jesus is the bridegroom. So when you think about marriage, it's an individual that says, I want to better someone else's life. Amen? So many times people think marriage is, we share bills, we share the same bed, we have children. Anybody can do that. You know, and when you look at today's society, I'll ask you a question. If people sleep together, they have sex together, they pay bills together, they can live like they're married, but God doesn't honor it. God will still consider it fornication, and if they die, they go to hell. But they will do everything that a regular marriage person, a married person would do. But when you decide to do it God's way, because when God brought Adam and Eve together, it was a holy matrimony. And you know, we are in a civilized society where you don't jump on a woman and another woman, or you know, let another man and another man. You can have one. You know, we're not the animal kingdom. Y'all could have laughed at that. It was funny. You know, because, you know, God desires for two people to be one. And like, say for example, you have sex with more than one person, you take on their personality, and then, and you know, you could be 3 o'clock in the morning and be like, why my wife climbing on the ceiling? It's cause that wolf man she slept with before she slept with you. And people think it's funny, but you know, you when you have multiple partners, you end up comparing. Was like an amen, maybe. So that's what marriage is. Marriage is, you know, the ideal marriage is when two virgins will come together, don't know anything, you know, and then they can grow together. But how many know in society you might not have an ideal start, but when you get born again, you're a virgin.
Amen.
Well, y'all might not want to agree with that, but that's how God sees you. And then you start afresh and anew. And I had, I had two thoughts for your wedding, you know, three that I want to share. And the first one was, sometimes when you know the person before the marriage, it could be good or it could be bad. And I believe you both going to be challenged because you know each other already. You know, and that, you know, it's like, it's 10 years, right? Almost 11, right? So let's do 10. I like the number 10. 10 is like perfect. And you know, you're still here. They all here. Everybody you love is here. Don't worry. And so what happens is, when you know a person already before you get married, you kind of set yourself up, and you don't enjoy the new. But I believe God's going to allow you to experience everything brand new. You know, because if you know everybody's faults already, you know, you don't give them the benefit of the doubt that they made a mistake. And so the word that God gave me was, Christ is the head of the man, and the head of the woman is the man. And in order for your marriage to be successful, you're going to have to allow Jesus to be the head of your life. You know, you're saved, but him being the head of your life will guarantee you a successful marriage. You know, weddings are easy. All you got to do is this. But marriage, it takes a lifetime. You know, it takes learning because, you know, two people becoming one doesn't happen overnight. It takes time. And because of the history that you share, the other verse that God gave me was grace. You're going to need grace for each other. You know, the Bible says, I believe in the epistles, it said you are to be joint heirs of the grace of life together. In other words, because you're getting married, all the favor of life becomes yours as long as you stay together. Because you're deciding to give your life to him. And you're deciding to give your life to her. So now the grace of life becomes your inheritance. You get to receive all the blessings that God has for you. You know, somebody asked me, you know, they thought gifts and money is the blessing of God. No, that's just gifts and money. You know, the blessing of God is when God's not against you. Because you have some of the richest sinners in the world. And some people would call them blessed. No, how can you be blessed on your way to hell? And Jesus said it's more blessed to give. So I believe in this wedding, in this marriage, I believe the two of you are going to get a fresh start. Amen. I believe you did not waste 10 years, but I believe you have not even begun to know what God's going to do for you, to you, and through you. This will not be a normal wedding. You will be an exemplary husband, you'll be an exemplary wife, and you're going to seek God on how to be the best husband, how to be the best wife, how to be the best father, and how to be the best mommy.
Amen.
Because when I lay hands on you, I'm going to believe God that you're going to be fruitful and multiply.
Amen.
And I'm not birth control, and I don't care what he say. When it become legal, open up the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. No, I can't sing. Don't worry about it. It's not what I do. And I believe that. I believe it. I believe you want a baby from him. And you want to give her babies. Come on. Because you know what? Listen, when God is for you, who can be against you? And you have to believe that our whole society, especially American society, you know, they're judging their families based on their income. I mean, God said be fruitful and multiply. He didn't say check your bank account before you have babies. He said get into bed and have a baby. All right. You know, be wise all you want and be lonely. When you get old, you have no children to come and help you. All right, that's a word for all y'all. The Bible says that the when you have a bunch of kids, they're like arrows. So when people come jump you, your kids come out. That's what the Bible says. You have one or two kids, somebody jump you, that's it. It's a wrap. All right, it's true. But you know, so when you look at marriage, Naima and Lamont become one person. God looks at one, and when because you've been born male, you know. That's why I can't understand how they're doing same-sex marriages. How does God see it? Because marriages is designed that people could come out of them. No? I think that's what he said. You know, he said, be fruitful and multiply. I guess, all right, whatever. It don't work. Because, you know, in the society, they can get married in society, right? But for God to honor it, he has to know that there could be fruit. And I believe you're going to bear fruit.
Amen.
Amen? Amen. You ready to... He said, you know I'm ready. I changed what he said, but I'm helping him by faith. At least you got to have 5 kids, right? You want 5 grandbabies, right? Yeah, oh, she said 6. No, she didn't. Don't look at that. I mean, a bunch of them. You know, can I just give you a little wisdom? The more children you have, the more favor you have, because God cares about your kids. Jesus, you ever heard of Jesus? His mother and father had no money. Mary and what's his name? Mary and Joseph, they had no money. They were broke. Jesus still got, God still got Mary pregnant. He said, I don't care how much money you got. But what happened? God told Joseph, he told the wise men, come bring them some money for that baby. And when Jesus was born, they brought gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Had enough money to book. So don't judge your life on your income. Jesus said a man's life consisteth not in the things that he possessed. It's the character of your heart. Amen. So don't be afraid. God don't give us fear. Fear is of the devil. But you got to be wise. Don't buy a Mercedes Benz. You ain't got no license. Right? Put Kool-Aid in your gas tank. Amen. Y'all heard me? So right now, what we're going to do is they have elected to light candles. We're going to come up here, first the moms of the bride and the groom, we're going to come up. And each one is going to light a candle, one for their family. You can light for your side of the room. All right, thank you. Yes, I'll bring you over.
Our Father, a child in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Stand over here. What they're going to do now is Naima's going to take the candle representing her family, and Lamont's going to take the candle representing his family, and together they're going to light the center candle and then blow out the individual candles. Take care.
On earth as it is in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Oh, amen.
You know, they have elected to do their own vows, and marriage is a vow. Marriage is a commitment that two people make to each other before God and before witnesses. And they're going to say what they vow to one another. And ladies first. Amen.
I left my vow.
Okay. It's still from the heart. Hold on. You want to? I'll hold this for you.
Lamont, you are my knight in shining armor. My happiness matters to you. You have been my ears when I couldn't hear. Most importantly, you taught me that giving up is not an option. Today I vow to be an honorable, respectful, virtuous, and submissive wife to you for the rest of my life. And may the mighty hand of God come upon us this day, that we together can walk in love, unity, prosperity, and good health. In Jesus' name, and must I add, I have waited for this day.
Amen. Hallelujah. If you must. Hallelujah. You ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Okay. Name of my queen. I love you. Today is a very special day. Long ago, you were just a dream and a prayer. I thank you for being what you are to me. Without future, as bright. As the bright promise of God, I will care for you, honor, and protect you. I lay down my life for you, for my friend and my lover. They look like they want to grab each other, but not yet. Come on. Can I have the rings? Let's just bless these. Now, Father, we thank you for this, these rings. Let them be a symbol of their unity. When anybody sees these rings, let them honor these rings and the bearers of these rings, that they're holy and they're married. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You know, a lot of people have stories about rings, never-ending circles, but I like my story. You know, you get two, maybe three rings in a wedding. First, you get the engagement ring. It's all right. He don't need this. It's too hard to cut his face anyhow. I think it's best to cry when you have reason to cry. I'm sorry. Once you get married, I won't take the tissues from you. And I believe you either have two rings or a three-ring marriage. You get the engagement ring, and then you get the wedding ring. And if you married the wrong person, you get the suffer ring. But I believe you married the right person. I believe you're going to have, I just believe it. I believe the enemy couldn't stop God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, cry.
Hallelujah.
Yes. She loved him.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's, it's always time. If you want to say it to, you can say it to. I'm not going to stop you.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, he came out with his tissue. He had his own spot. He had his own his stash. Amen.
Amen.
Well, you go first. Can you handle your ring finger? Is that the right hand? Yeah, why is this? Oops. Ready? Grab his hand. Say, with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
It is a token of my faith and love.
It is a token of my faith and love.
And this is forever.
And this is forever.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. It's
going to
grow.
Amen. You ready?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Yes. You want to breathe in again? You're not going to fall, right? All right. You ready? Say this with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
It is a token of my faith and love.
It's a token of my faith and love.
And this is forever.
And this is forever.
Do it with emphasis. And this is forever.
And this is forever.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, put the ring on the finger. Hallelujah. Hold this.
Amen.
Father, in Jesus' name, I bless you in the name of the Lord. Father, bless them coming in. Bless them going out. Bless everything that they put their hands to. Bless their body. Bless their store. Prosper them. Help them. Keep them healthy and whole. I pronounce the blessing of God upon you. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, I plead the blood of Jesus over you to protect you against enemies seen and unseen. And I decree and declare by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ, and in the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may, You may now kiss your bride.
You better get